Hello students and friends, welcome back to my session on Arduino in 21 days. We are in day 5. Now yesterday we saw about the Arduino program for 16x2 LCD display program without any I2C interface. But in today's session we will see with the help of I2C, I think somebody will say I2C, somebody will say I2C. Okay, I am saying it as I2C. You can say it as I2C or I2C. Okay, your wish. Our idea is to solve the problem, that's all. Okay, we may make some mistake, but the end result must be pakka. Okay, so this is the nano board. So this document anyway I'll be giving. So this is the LCD module we'll be using. Yesterday we used these connections. Okay, this is without I2C. Okay, anyway I'll be showing you now. So here without I2C it uses D1 2 4 5 6 digital inputs. These things are not required. I am deleting it. In addition to this LCD display, you have to purchase a I2C module. Hardly it is somewhere between 100 to 200 rupees only. Okay, these two things should be fused together. So this is the ICT module available separately. Okay, so here you see there are only four pins. The first pin you connect it to ground. Okay, the second pin VCC plus 5 volt, then this SDA to be connected to analog A4, analog input of A4. Okay, where is it? So it is here on this pin number 23. Okay, then SCL to be connected with A5, analog input 5, pin number 24. That's all. So from this you will one thing you should notice, see in the previous case, in the previous problem is same LCD display with yesterday we saw about without I2C module that required 6 digital inputs, but this require 2 analog inputs actually. So we will be saving 6 digital inputs. It's a great thing I could say, because digital input and output points are very much essential for your project, for the execution of your project. We'll be hardly using all the analog channels, so let we spare the analog channel for the LCD display using this actually. Okay, then one more thing, you please make it now itself. This is called the trim part. You have to adjust it. Only if you adjust it, then only you will get a, you can see a display in the LCD module. So if, again I repeat, if you are able to get a display in the LCD module, well and good. Otherwise you have to adjust it using a small screwdriver. You please the plus symbol is here, you know, so fix the screwdriver here and just either clockwise or anti-clockwise you rotate it, so until you get the display. So this is connected. Now you see this is the LCD display and this is the I2C module. Both has been soldered together. So this is the backside view. The close-up view, of course. This is the front side view. Okay. So behind this, it has I2C module. So you see there are 4 wires. There are 4 wires. 1 2 3 4 maybe yes this is ground, VCC, SDA, SDL, that is analog input A4, analog input A5, that's it. Okay, so again the idea is we have eliminated all the 6 digital inputs that we used in the previous problem. So the wire connection, as I said earlier, there are only 4 wires in this particular module. There are 4 connections: ground plus 5, SDA to A4 analog input, SCL, A5 in Arduino to analog input. Then make a note of it. You have to install necessary libraries in the Arduino IDE. Okay, in the program I'll show you. Then you have to adjust the part just before I said in the I2C board to get the proper display. That's all. We go to the program. This is the program. So this program is available in this Word file. I'll convert this as a PDF and I'll attach this in the description as a link. Okay, by clicking a link, you can download everything. So this particular thing has the Arduino board, nano board detail, LCD detail, the I2C module, the connectivity. Okay, here everything is here, right? So this is the program. Okay, so the wire header file and LCD liquid crystal I2C header file. These two are important. Maybe I think this will be initializing the thing. What we are using is 16 by 2 display, 16 character 2 line display. In the market, 16 by 4 is also available. 16 character 4 rows, that is also available. Okay. Now I told you, know in the sketch include library. In that, I struggled a lot. I nearly spent almost half a day in. Installing the proper library file. Okay, again I repeat, if you are not installing it, now you see this is red in color, this is red in color, this is red in color. Okay, if the libraries are not installed properly, this won't be in red in color. Okay, so it is nothing but the visual programming. Okay, visual based programming, it follows a color code. Okay, the program is following a color code. So once it is you are getting their red color display, that means the library is properly installed. Maybe even there are many libraries available for each and everything, especially in Arduino, not only for this LCD, even for many other things. Okay, so you may think that you installed a library, but the proper library should be installed. So that means you have to install the many such libraries. You see, now I manage library, just go to it. Now I install many libraries here, many libraries here. Okay, if I type LCD, press enter. So this is one library is installed, other is installed. So then only I'm able to get the solution properly. Okay, now this is the program. So I said Arduino has got as only two blocks, setup block, loop block. Setup block, initialization, lcd.init, it initializes the LCD backlight, it turns on the backlight actually. So those initializations can be done in the setup block. So let us see in the loop block. So let me clear the screen first. I'm setting the cursor at 0th row, that is the first row. Okay, first character, 0th character. So 0 to 15, there are 15 characters. So the first line is hello, the second line is my name, I'm Senthil Kumar. It will be there for 2 seconds. After that, again it is cleared. Then welcome friends and students. This is for 2 seconds. So the loop continues again. So hello Senthil Kumar for 2 seconds, welcome friends and students for 2 seconds. We'll see that. I compiled it already. So let me play this. Hello Senthil Kumar, friends and students. Okay, now in place of Senthil Kumar, you can type your own text. Your own text. I typed something like this. Ha 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 ha. And I got it. I just made these two changes. Then after compiling, this is the button for compiling. Okay, I already compiled everything. So I'll show you the result of the second one. Okay, so let me undo it. So whatever text that you require between the strings, it should have 16 characters. Space is also one character. Okay. So this is how you can write a program. Okay. So I told you already. Again, I reiterated. I am not an expert in Arduino, but I am an object man actually. I fix the object. Okay. I'll try my level best to achieve that and make that object. That's it. Okay. Whether that requires some amount of electronics or some amount of Arduino or some amount of even civil, so I will just employ it. Okay, if I am able to do it, I'll do it on my own. Otherwise, I'll get it from someone. Okay, so that's it for today. This everything is there. Okay, so I'll be copying everything in the as a PDF file. You'll get all these things in the YouTube thing under the description as a link. So you can not only see the video, you can get the full description, full content as a PDF file under the link. Thank you.